Hi, this is Dr. A with your anatomy and physiology review of the male reproductive system. So the function of the male reproductive system is to produce sperm and then to deliver the sperm to the female reproductive tract and to secrete the male hormones. The organs of the male reproductive system are the testes, epididymis, vas deferens, seminal vesicle, prostate gland, bulbourethral gland, and penis. The major organs of the male reproduction are located externally. External organs include the penis and two testes, each with an epididymis. The penis contains the urethra, which carries both urine and sperm. Internal organs include the two seminal vesicles, two vas deferens, one prostate, and two bulbourethral glands. So here is all of the anatomy. So if we start from where sperm is produced, so from the testes right here, with the epididymis right here, then we go to the vas deferens. There's two of those, one attached to each testicle, and then it wraps around the bladder. Here's the bladder, and joins with the seminal vesicle here into the prostate, where it joins the urethra. Out, and then this is penis, so that gives you kind of a quick overview of where everything is located. The testes are oval shaped and produce sperm in the seminiferous tubules. They maintain a lower temperature via suspension in the scrotum, and that's for optimal sperm production. Testosterone is produced in the testes, and it's the primary androgen, so testosterone gives males all of their male features. It is responsible for the development of the male sex organs, for the development of sperm, and the secondary sex characteristics, which are the deeper voice, the larger muscle mass, the facial hair, etc. Here is an illustration of sperm. The epididymis is a coil tube, tube-shaped organ. One lies on top of each testes with the scrotum. Within the scrotum. The sperm mature and are stored in the epididymis, and then when the sperm are ready, they are released into the vas deferens. The penis delivers the sperm into the female vagina. The soft tip is a glans penis, and it is covered by the prepuce or foreskin unless it has been removed. The penis becomes erect during sexual stimulation to allow for the insertion in the female and the ejaculation of semen into the female so that fertilization can happen. The urethra carries the semen out of the male body. Each vas deferens carries the sperm from the epididymis into the pelvic cavity. They travel in front of the bladder, over the top, and down the back of the bladder to the urethra. The vas deferens is part of the spermatic cord, along with the nerves, the arteries, and the veins, and the lymph vessels, and those are the ones that feed into the testes. The two seminal vesicles are small glands at the base of the bladder, and they connect to the vas deferens right before it empties into the urethra, and they release a glucose-rich fluid that nourishes the sperm and allows it to swim so that hopefully it can fertilize an egg. This fluid, along with the sperm and other secretions, make up the semen. The prostate gland, there's one prostate gland. It is located just below the urinary bladder. It surrounds the urethra and can cause trouble in urinating if the prostate is enlarged. The prostate secretes an alkaline fluid into the semen, and this fluid neutralizes the pH of the urethra and of the vagina and helps the sperm survive. The two small bulbourethral glands are located on either side of the urethra below the prostate, and they secrete a mucus-like fluid that joins the semen. And here's again a review of the anatomy. So we have the testes, epididymis, vas deferens that loops, picks up secretions from the seminal vesicle, and the prostate joins with the urethra. Here's the little bulbourethral gland. Out the urethra through the penis and the glans penis. So that wraps up our anatomy of the male reproductive system.